solidarity, and together I think we constitute a heartfelt concern with Poland. When sanctions and martial law were imposed, as you know, they said if they wanted to improve relations, they would have to lift those restrictions on their people. Martial law was removed in 1983, and thousands of political prisoners freed through amnesties, and since September, the amnesty of September, no one has been arrested. We do feel that Poland still has a long way to go. The free trade unions are stifled and independent political activity repressed, and genuine national reconciliation has not been achieved. Solidarity in the Polish church, however, urged us to lift the sanctions, finding as something that we were concerned about even before that, that perhaps those sanctions were hindering the very people we wanted to help, the people of Poland. And after careful review and drawing out a long cross-section of views from church, solidarity, allies, and Congress, having conducted talks with the Polish government, I decided that those sanctions imposed on December of 81 and October of 82 should be rescinded. And I'm lifting the ban on Polish eligibility for official U.S. credit and credit guarantees. However, continuation of better relations is possible only if respect for human rights is maintained and national reconciliation restored. So we'll be watching to see that further steps toward that are taken. Progress made is not reversed. Freedom is precious to us. The slogan of Polish independence struggle of the last century was, when they did that, their slogan was for your freedom and ours. Well, that's our slogan to progress action. Today's a new step, a big step, and I hope our relations with Poland can develop, move ahead along the genuine progress toward national reconciliation. I think that's enough talking for me.
Right now that the sanctions have been removed. And I want to thank you very much for your concern about the people of Poland and solidarity. And we pray and we hope and pray that after this is done today, that the relationship will improve and also the situation in Poland will be such that it will be more palatable to the United States and all freedom-loving people. So thank you again, sir.
Well, I'm pleased to do it. Incidentally, some of you have heard or are interested in reading some very informative things about Poland, World War II history and on. I received a gift from the former ambassador to the United States from Poland.
He's here to rep by sitting too. Yeah.
Nice to be here, Mr. President. Well, I was at a historic meeting when the sanctions were imposed, and rightly so. Now they are lifted, and rightly so.
Well, and I can thank you for your book, which you graciously sent to me, and tell all these people I have read it, and really deeply moved, and I think thoroughly informed as to the agony of Poland, what has happened regarding the relationship with the Soviet Union. I couldn't put it down.
Thank you very much.
You kept me waiting on my street. Thank you. I think I'm going up to the door and then we'll have a chance to visit with anybody. Bye. Good pictures.
Okay.
Present, Mr. and Mrs.
Clemens. Oh. Yes. Clem, hi. How are you?
And
Father Ritter.
Yes.
Mr. President, how do you do? Thank you very much. It's a great honor to receive your award.
We're very pleased to be able to be a part of this.
I think it's time we got lunch.
They want to get a photo here of everyone, all cameras.
Sure.
Okay.
You're the... Now, in addition, here we go. Just some souvenirs of your visit to the Oval Office.
Thank you very much.
With that, why don't you come on?
Hello.
This is
my private representative. Who are the voters? It was an honor.
I'm just giving away souvenirs.
Oh, thank you very much.
Glad you're back for the ladies.
You want to stand?
Yeah, I know you won't wear it formally then, but...
Oh, that's beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you.
Sister Patty.
Yeah.
It's such an honor.
See all of you.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.
Please be able to participate in this, knowing what you have done.
Thank you very much. It's good work that we do.
They want to get, Mary Ann wants to get one family photo here, one group photo.
Okay.
Everybody can move down this way just a little bit. All right.
Who would you like to...
Somebody want to send it and his family.
Some could come right over here where I am.
That's great. Thank you.
Thank you.
And we join the family.
I need to have him come in much tighter.
Thank you.
There we are.
Thank you.
Well, like millions of others, we pray for you daily.
Well, thanks.
And the Lord's been good to all of us.
If sometime you get busy, you can ask me in there.
Stay well. Thank you very much.
It's been a pleasure.
Was that another 8 years?
You know Ed James?
Yes.
President. You also know Ollie Del Shaw.
Brought you a letter from the Chamber of Commerce. I'd like to leave here with you.
Thank you very much.
Oh, it's Mobile. Good to see you again.
Thank you. Yeah.
Mr. President, they bless you. You're looking great.
You want to feel good.
You look great.
I think maybe they want us to...
If we can get a picture of this one. I want to say to you on behalf of the Chamber and the business community generally that what you've done in the past 6 years has really rejuvenated the business in this country. And we're thankful for that. We're inspired by what you said on Tuesday afternoon. And we're behind that program 100% and everything you can do.
Well, I'm glad to hear that because I think there is a certain kinship between your program and the thing that we've suggested about excellence and all that. You've been of so much help before on other things, and glad to have it again on this.
Thank you. You just have to pick the same thing, and we got to keep America on top.
And yes. So, can't let you leave without some souvenirs.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Appreciate it.
That's wonderful. Thank you so much.
Good to hope to see you down in Mobile way in the following day. Thank you down in Alabama. Yeah. Guys down. Great job.
Oh, yeah. It's a great team.
Really strong.
I've So did I in 5 minutes. Oh, that's great. That's great.
Thank you very much.
All right. Good to see you again.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you.
The next 2 years represents 25% of your administration, and we want to be with you to make sure that you get that 100% because the country needs it.
Thank you very much.
We're having the 70.
I just ain't about to sit back and relax for 2 years.
This year will be the 75th anniversary of the year that President Taft founded the U.S. Chamber of Commerce. We've invited you to speak to our annual meeting on April 27th, and that 75th commemorative anniversary. We hope you'll be able to do that.
This is Tony Boyles, Mr. President.
Yes. Good to have you here.
And coming to the door is Gretchen Rosenkranz.
Oh, well, we could talk about that. Would you just step over here in the room?
Tony, please. Come just back up with the president. Yeah, right next to him.
Right next to him.
There you go, buddy.
Well, it's nice to see you.
And his parents. Stay here,
Greg. The others are coming in.
Their parents will be coming in just a second.
Well, you two are doing a very wonderful thing.
Back in. You're not supposed to.
A bunch of dimes. Wiped out polio. And now it's at work wiping out something else, and you're very much a part of this. The national ambassadors.
This is Tony's father, Mr. President.
Oh,
it's a pleasure, Mr. President.
His mother, Donna Boyles.
Hello there.
And his sister, Tanya.
Hello there. How are you?
And Brian Rosenkranz.
Hello there. Good to see you.
Gretchen's mother, Paula Rosenkranz.
Hello there.
And Gretchen's sister, Shelley.
Hello. Good to see you.
Mary Greenwood, Board of Trustees.
Hello.
Vice Chairman of the National
Board. Hello. Well, pleasure to meet you. Just telling the children what a wonderful thing they're contributing to and the good that can be done.
Mr. President, there's one more person, Diane Sarator.
Hello there.
Nice to meet you.
Communications manager.
Well, now, just 1 minute here. There are two ambassadors, but I think maybe I'd better give these to them. These are jelly bean jars filled with jelly beans.
Oh, no.
Who would like that?
Maybe the parents would have that for them.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Now, some other souvenirs here, too.
What is good on
a I better wait and come back for some beans. Just along with it. The gentlemen. Whether in uniform or not, just to see your
thank you, sir.
From the Oval Office.
Thank you.
So now, with the ladies, pins.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Thank you. There. Well, all right. And you have yours.
Yes.
Consumer.
Well, but also
the Bill of Rights.
Yes, tied in with that 200th year.
Virginia. Mr. President. Wonderful to see you again.
It's good to see you, Mr. President. Nice to see you, Mr. President.
Steve, Mr. President.
Yeah, oh, it's on the desk.
Ashby Watt.
We're going to have everyone gather behind the desk here.
The National Consumers Week proclamation, and that is very dependent on the Constitution. All of that. Now. That makes it official. And the week will begin on the 19th day of April. All right.
I'd like to present our last year's report. We had over 450 different volunteer groups around the country putting on reaching 75 people. And Pat Thaley here, who read the receiving line as our national champion. She's doing her third year and doing a beautiful job.
Thank you.
Sir, may I present, this is the poster Sears has had prepared for this National Consumers Week. It shows the
Consumers' Bill of Rights.
Yes.
Consumers celebrate the Constitution, yeah. That is our slogan.
And that's, and yes, of course, that's the theme of...
You and your five predecessors have endorsed the Consumers' Bill of Rights, so we sort of tie it all together. And I'd like to say that Sears, this is the fourth year, Mr. President, that Sears has done. This is how I stretch my budget.
You just keep that up.
Yes. Remember, yes, I'll do it next year.
Mr. President,
this is a more complete description of the Consumer's Bill of Rights. Thank you very much.
And Mr. Wilmuth and the National Futures Association are partners this year, and they have given us $200,000, so we send it all over the country.
Out of the budget process. Yeah.
That's augmenting my budget a bit.
Private sector partners.
Yes.
Private sector partners.
Yes. That's very dear to my heart.
Thank you very much.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
So we go this way? Thank you so much. It's been a great...
Anyway.
Get around the back here, so we're going to...
Thank you for doing it.
My deputy.
Mr. President, you got a lot of support out of this.
Yeah. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Hi, Mr. President, Ambassador Gillespie.
Yes, nice to see you again, Mr. President. It's good to see you. Nice to be up here.
Well,
I feel like I'm really up here for a few days. Well, we've been a long time after getting this picture taken.
Yes, we have.
Thank you.
Well, I want to tell you, we think it was a great thing, the arrest of Leder, bringing him up here.
Your letter was well received, but I'm going to tell him that... President, we just had this little chat, and you want to encourage him to keep going, and he will.
Yes, but also, I want to thank you because I know that's, you got to look before you cross the street.
Look there every time.
And that and all of your personnel, please tell all of them.
They're doing a super job.
You're really serving in a hot seat now.
Thank you very much.
And that, well, just a little souvenir.
Oh, thank you so much.
But I know that, and that press thing last week, that took a lot of courage.
That's ridiculous.
They have really put themselves out in front there.
A lot of brave people trying to do a tough job, and they've appreciated everything you and Nancy have done, I guess, last June and September, our meeting in November. So
all of you keep as careful as you possibly can.
Okay.
Take advantage of all the security that's available.
Thanks, buddy.
All right. Bless you.
Oh, yes. Sir, an honor to meet you.
Well, it's an honor to have you here.
Thank you.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
The Browns found out we were coming here. They went into a panic and insisted that we get you to start wearing a little Cleveland paraphernalia.
Oh, for heaven's sakes. Hey, thank you very much. We'll just throw that over there.
A little mess.
Well...
seen that on the sidelines before.
Mayo.
Or Ohio.
Yeah, we have some Cleveland fans working around here, huh?
Thank you.
And this is one of his specials.
Marketing device.
Well, say.
Let's take it out and get a grip on it.
Mm-hmm. Might want to use it.
Upset
to rip
the picture.
Yeah, try to do it without that. Hey.
Offensive lineman though, aren't supposed to throw passes. Ex-offensive lineman.
Except that in my day, you were offense and defense. You played the whole game. As a matter of fact, in my last 3 years in college, I averaged over 3 minutes of every game.
You can throw it back to the left.
I don't know if I want to throw it.
Well, listen, thank you very much. I had a little fun with this. But, well, it's good to see you. I was a right guard. My one adventure that I remember and served me very well in later years was a missed block. Back in my era was when Rockne at Notre Dame had just thought about the thing of guards coming out of the line on interference. So on most of our plays, instead of getting the man opposite, why, I would
run around.
We had one play, it was an off-tackle smash, quarterback carrying the ball, and the whole key was me getting the first man in the secondary. Out around, hidden, and we only had about 20 seconds left to go in the game, behind 1 point, and about 65 yards to go. We're back in our own territory, and we called, instead of a pass, called that play. Bud Cole, our quarterback, went out, cut back, reversed his field down the sideline, and made the touchdown. And I never figured out how he did it because I missed the block. I didn't get the man I was supposed to get. But after I graduated, my audition led to a sports announcer. I wanted a job in radio. And a program director heard me mention sports. And he asked me, well, I was on my way out. They didn't have any job for me. He caught up with me at the elevator, and he said, what was that you said about sports? And I said, well, I'd like to be a sports announcer someday. And he said, what do you know about football? And I said, played it 8 years. And he said, could you tell me about a game and make me see it? And I said, I think so. He took me in a studio, stood me in front of a microphone, said, when the red light goes on, I won't be in here. I'll be someplace else listening. You broadcast an imaginary football game for me.
Oh, I think you said this at to Bob Costas, didn't you, during the Fiesta Bowl, was that?
Say, by golly, I did tell that.
I think so. Yeah, I didn't know it was that.
And the thing was, so what I did was take that game in the last quarter. I thought, I could remember names, the other fellows as well as our guys, and wouldn't have to fish around for names in the imaginary broadcast. So I brought us all the way up to that point. And I have to tell you, this time on the replay, I got that fellow with the biggest block you ever saw. I made quite a deal out of it. That's right, I'd forgotten I did say that.
Yeah, because I went to Miami, so I was watching that game with a little bias towards it.
Yeah, I can see that.
Yeah.
Well, by golly, good to see
you. Yeah, and for imagining how busy you are, I appreciate you taking the time out to see us.
Pleased to do it. I'm not totally empty-handed either. Just a couple of little souvenirs here at the Oval Office.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hey, are you flying out this afternoon?
Up to Camp David, yes. It's kind of an escape.
Have a good speech this afternoon, too.
Thank you.
Thanks again, sir.
All right, thank you very much. I've got to get some of the Secret Service to. Maybe we can go in for a little touch football. You know, the funny thing was, I was a guard. Practice and everything. I was the best passer.
I was going to say, you had too much talent with the ball there. I should have handed off once in a while or threw it or did something with it.
In those days, you used to come out on the field before the game early and then just break up and your team and X are warming up, throwing passes to each other. And the receivers would all seek me out to pass to them.
Is that right?
There I was a guard and I was throwing the passes.
Must have been the best athlete on the team. I said,
oh, not really.
Well, if you could block and pass, I mean, that's everything with tackling, and you did that too.
See, I think I better hang on to that, hadn't I? No.
Put it in there?
Yeah. Oh, I thought I might just keep it handy where sometime I wanted to throw it around, I could throw it around.
You want me to put it in the closet here in my little corner?
Okay, all right.
Where I keep the other fun things like the golf club and the ball and the Vigo stamp? Okay.